Hello at the internet land. I am Scruffy Matt. This is Scruffy's Retro Corner, looking at the games from yesteryear. The good, the... Well, hopefully only the good. I mean, why would I want to waste my time playing bad games? That's just no fun at all. Hello, hello. I am back from vacation. It has been a hot minute since I had my last stream, hasn't it? Already see some of you wandering into the chat. Thank you. Dom Klein, welcome. I know you've been eager for me to continue this game. You messaged me a couple of times, checking in on when I'd be back. Thank you. Do appreciate the interest in the stream. I've only been back in the country for a few days. I spent 3 weeks in North America, largely in California, then Edmonton, then Toronto. My partner and I, and her best friend and her daughter, we went to Disneyland together and Universal Studios, as well as San Diego Zoo. And then we took a trip to Toronto in the last week of my trip to go to Fan Expo, where I got to meet one of my favorites, current writer of the Sonic comics and also the Sonic games, Ian Flynn himself. I got one of his autographs in reach. I do. Hang on. So he autographed my copy of Sonic Frontiers and several comics as well. Also got to meet Aaliyah Baker, who previously wrote for the Archie Sonic the Hedgehog series, and she autographed some stuff for me as well. Very, very nice people. So kind, and just a genuine pleasure to meet them. I don't want to speak for Dom, but I'm sure we're both glad you're enjoying AA so far. Oh, thank you, Chet. I've been really enjoying it. Kind of sad that I had to put it on hold for a while. I was tempted to go on and play it myself, but I decided to wait until I was back on stream, and so here we are. So I guess we should get into it. Last time I was here, as I recall, it was the trial of the Silver Samurai, who had been framed for killing his co-star, who was the villain of the show. And as I recall, when it became clear what was going on, Miles Edgeworth, who is the prosecuting attorney, actually was subtly helping us to close the case. But then afterwards, he told us, hey, bugger off, I never want to see you again. So I wonder if we're now going to follow up on that little thread, see what happened. Yeah, it's cool. Doug had another flare-up last night, and our other friend who streams on Fridays is pretty much the online equivalent of a missing person at this point. He hasn't streamed once in 3 weeks. He normally streams 2 to 3 times a week. While he usually does, he never said anything about taking a break or vacation, and all attempts on both our ends to reach him have failed. And chat can speak for you. Okay. That's disappointing. I hope that your other friend is okay, and that they'll be back online soon. If you guys are looking for messages or announcements from me, it's usually going to be on my Twitter account, which is linked down below if you want to check that out. But you know, I'll say this stuff in the streams as well when I can. But yeah, if I'm not going to be able to stream at the weekends, it's usually on Twitter. I'll announce it. All right, shall we continue the game then? Loading content. Getting a little worrying. Yeah. Well, I have my fingers crossed for you. Oh, God, that hurts. I'm too old to be crossing my fingers anymore. I might just turn down my volume a little bit. It's been, what, 15 years? About that, yes. 15 years is a long time to wait. You can't imagine how much I've suffered. You've suffered? But now, the perfect opportunity has presented itself. At last, I shall have my revenge. Dun dun dun. What? Merry Christmas. Dang. Miles! What have you done? Are you going to do the others after finishing this? I won't be disappointed, if not just curious. To be determined. There are other games I would like to also play on stream, but I've been enjoying this one. I dare say I would, you know, at the very least come back to some of the other games in the series somewhere down the track. But yeah, might end up playing something else after I finish this first one. Yeah, we'll see what happens, I guess. Depends on my mood at the end of this one. Hey, Nick! Gotta try and remember the voices I had in my head for all these people before I went away. Do you know if there are any good waterfalls around here? Waterfalls? Dare I ask why? Duh, Nick! Isn't it obvious? I need a waterfall to stand in, preferably a freezing one. She's still got samurais in her head, hasn't she? Oh, is that part of your spirit medium training? Of course, except I've been slacking off lately. I need to brave the elements and be forged anew under the rushing spring waters. Okay, I thought it was more of a martial arts thing. Okay. I don't know about any falls per se, but Gourd Lake is pretty close. Oh, great. Yeah, let's go and look at the corpse in the water. Wonderful. Oh, darn. Sorry, but them's the breaks. Couldn't you just take a cold shower or something? Good idea! So much for rushing spring waters. Next in the news, a large unidentified animal was sighted at Gourd Lake. The town is buzzing with excitement. Locals are calling it Gordy, and a tip of the hat to Nessie, the Loch Ness Monster. Yeah, I mean, one of the places I went to while I was on my vacation was the Ripley's Aquarium in Toronto, and one of the exhibits there had a little bit about the Loch Ness Monster. Taking a good look at the photo, I can't just help but wonder, you know, if what that photo of, you know, the supposed head sticking out of the water, if it's not just someone's arm kind of going like this, you know? You know what I mean? I'm the Loch Ness Monster. Just a theory. Though its namesake Nessie proved to be a hoax, has it, though? Locals are confident their Gordy is the real deal. Boring. Can't they share the real news for a change? Nick? The water pressure's kind of low in that shower. You want more pressure, huh? Why don't you go down to the fire department and have them spray you with the... Good idea, Nick! Apparently, Fey Blood is no aid in detecting sarcasm. We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. Strange occurrences continue at Gord Lake, but this time it's murder. Gord Lake again? The body of a man was found in the lake early this morning. A suspect was apprehended. Sources inside the police department revealed that the suspect's name is Miles Edgeworth, age 24. Edgeworth was an up-and-coming prosecutor known for his skill and connections. He was guaranteed a long and rewarding career. Has he thrown it all away? Huh? Edgeworth? What's going on? Edgeworth would never do something like... Nick? Oh no. Yeah, it's... Maya? The fireman yelled at me when I called him. We got bigger things to worry about than that. They arrested Edgeworth. What? You mean the prosecutor? Yeah, he's a suspect in a murder. What? When? Where? Who? Why? How? I mean, I guess that covers all the important questions, doesn't it? I don't know. Let's go find out, Nick. Mia's favorite plant. Its name is Charlie. Maya's gotten the knack of watering on lately. Charlie's been perking up these days. It looks like it's cleaning day again at the hotel across the way. I hear they're planting a second branch outside the city. I can see the bellboy getting the angle of that screwdriver in the drawer just right. Mia's desk. If we had more clients, I would probably sit here more often. Lately, I've been spending more time on the couch watching TV. Slack. Maya bought in a poster of the Steel Samurai the other day. We had a big fight over whether to put it up or not. Oh, come on, Phoenix, be nice. I know she's just waiting for a chance to sneak it up on the wall. Let her put up the Steel Samurai. It would be a good memento of your case. Come on, man. Advertise. You solved the murder of the what's his name? The bad guy. A difficult looking legal book stand in a formidable row. They mock me. I tried reading one and it made my head hurt. When I closed it, it slipped out of my hand, then my foot hurt too. You know, I had a similar experience in a Dungeons and Dragons game I've been playing with my friends. A while back, we were in a library, and everyone, you know, decided, yeah, well, okay, let's look for some books. And everyone else, they rolled really high, and they found exactly what they were looking for. So I decided to be a smartass and said, I want to find a book that is going to help us get out of this situation we're in as soon as possible. I rolled a natural one. And a book fell off the shelf, landed on my foot, really heavy book. So I took like 2 points of book damage. And it fell open on a page that just said, no, LOL. Alright, I suppose we should be traveling somewhere, shouldn't we? Or we could talk. Well, what should we do? What do you mean? Let's investigate. We should talk to Mr. Edgeworth and check out the crime scene. You're right, we need more information. Save homelessness and confusion for later. Well, got any good ideas? Not really. I do my best thinking when I'm standing underneath a waterfall. I mean, don't we all? Alright, let's talk to Miles first. If he'll even see us. That last case didn't exactly end amicably, did it? You know, Nick, we've all been in here one time or another, haven't we? I guess it comes with the territory. I'm not sure it's something we should mention to too many people. Yeah. Hey, Edgeworth, come back. He does not look happy.
What are you doing here, Long?
That's the voice I used for him last time, isn't it? Nick, I don't think he's in a very good mood. Well, duh, Maya. He's been arrested and accused of murder. Murder. Well, he is in detention. Were you in a good mood when you were here?
So you've come to laugh at the fallen attorney? Then laugh, laugh. Well, why aren't you laughing?
Nick, should we be laughing? Nah, it's a trick. Laugh and he'll get mad. Or burst into tears. He doesn't strike me as the burst into tears kind of guy. Edgeworth, we don't have so much free time we can spend it coming down here to laugh at you.
Yes, you do.
Actually, he's right.
I hoped you wouldn't come. I didn't want you to see me. Not like this.
I didn't want to see you like this either, believe me. Edgeworth, tell me what happened.
Why should I? What are you going to do about
Duh! We're going to help you, that's what.
Help me, you? Don't be ridiculous.
Sorry?
You're a novice. You've only been in three trials.
Hey!
Sure, you got lucky and won all three, but your luck's bound to run out someday. You need real skill, right? Experience.
Nick, he's insulting you! Nick? Why am I always the one who has to get angry? The murder took place at God Whack, correct?
Yes, late last night.
The lake is a long way from your offices and the courthouse. Why were you down there?
I see no need to tell you.
Mr. Edgeworth, you didn't really.
Gordy.
Huh?
I went to see Gordy.
Gordy? What's that? I'll tell you later. Why won't Edgeworth talk to us? All right, shall we have a look around? I doubt there's anything special here that we haven't seen in the previous cases. Smile for the camera. This guard monitors the visitor's room. He hasn't moved an inch since I came in. Real pro. Or maybe he's just nervous with Edgeworth in the room. Fair. Edgeworth can be intimidating. When he's not being a complete clown.
Your attorney's badge?
Edgeworth, let me defend you.
Ha! Ha ha! Good one, right? But I'm not that hard up, not yet.
What do you mean by that?
Me? Trust a wet behind the ears lawyer with only three trials under his belt? Never!
What?
My case is near hopeless, right? Every defense attorney I've talked to has turned me down.
What?
Simply put, they were afraid they'd lose. It occurred to me that it might be my fault that they lack confidence. After all, I did get every single one of their clients declared guilty.
I don't believe it.
Regardless, I don't want you involved in this. You, in particular, I cannot ask to do this.
Well, we tried. I guess that's the end of the game, right? All right, fine. We'll go to stupid God Lake for idiots. This is where it happened?
Yeah. Good Lake is in the middle of this park.
I can see some police walking around in there.
Questioning people, probably.
Hey, isn't that Detective Gumshoe over there?
Well, pal!
I think that's the voice I use for him.
There's enough of us here. Anyone found anything?
Sorry, sir. Nothing.
Idiot! The trial's tomorrow! We need clues on the double.
But sir... There weren't any clues. That's why we arrested that attorney, Mr. Edgeworth. It's clear, sir. He's the one...
Shut up! Just you try saying that again. I'll make you sorry if you do. So just get out of my face, pal.
He doesn't seem to be having a good day, does he? Seems a bit off.
Yes, sir.
Detective Gumshoe's kind of scary today.
Recruits. Peh. Ah.
Eek.
Hey, you're that Harry guy. Harry Butts.
No. I don't like Harry Butts, no.
Right, Phoenix. Right,
Phoenix Wright. Will he ever learn my name?
And just what are you doing here, pal? Investigating?
Well, yes, I suppose.
Well, I am here to help. Ask me anything you want. Bring it!
Okay. He's being surprisingly cooperative.
He seems different than usual. I wonder what's up. Mr. Edgeworth hasn't actually asked us to defend him yet.
Huh? Oh, you don't say.
Detective Gumshoe, do you know what happened here?
Huh? Oh, you don't know, pal?
No.
Wow, okay. Mr. Head in the Fluffy Pink Clouds lawyer.
Head in the... Huh?
Never mind, I'll tell you. It happened last night, about 15 minutes after midnight. There was a boat out on Gourd Lake. In that boat were two men. One of those men shot the other with a pistol. And the shooter...
And the shooter was Mr. Edgeworth?
A cop who arrived on the scene arrested him.
How did they get here so fast?
Well, there was a witness. When the report came in, we raced to the lake.
A witness?
Who was this witness?
Sorry, pal. That's confidential. Anyway, the witness saw everything, apparently. I'm sure they'll turn up at the trial tomorrow.
I wonder if the witness was the actual killer.
Was there only that one witness?
Yep, it was pretty cold out on the lake last night. And it was Christmas Eve, after all.
Wait, why the hell are Phoenix and Maya in the office on Christmas Day?
Still, we're being thorough. You never know when you're going to turn up another witness. That's why we're here today, checking things out. So far, we're coming up empty.
Oh, it's Christmas today. I'd forgotten. What are you getting me for Christmas, Nick?
Talk to Santa.
You don't think Mr. Edgeworth is a... murderer, do you?
Absolutely not. It's impossible. I don't care if there's a witness either. I don't believe I'm licking it.
So that's why he's so hostile. He really wants to find that evidence that's gonna clear Miles.
Right. Who cares what the witness says?
I care.
You really believe in him, don't you, Detective?
Of course I do. But... the police are pretty sure he's the killer. Nobody's even really taking this investigation that seriously.
Sounds like typical police to me.
Oh no!
After all the help Mr. Edgeworth has been to us, hard to imagine that no one's standing up to take his side. Well, at least you are, Detective. At least you are. Is it true? No one will take Mr. Edgeworth's case?
Yeah. He's a bit of a celebrity. If you defended him and lost, your reputation would be sure to suffer. What's more, the case against him is, well, it's pretty solid.
I suppose it would be if they have a witness.
Hey, Bao! Don't tell me you're gonna turn your back on him too. Remember the Steel Samurai case? Mr. Edgeworth helped you get your client declared innocent.
I know. I went to Edgeworth. I tried. He really doesn't want us to represent him. Especially not us, he said.
What? Well, that doesn't make any sense, pal. You should have heard him talking about you after that trial. He kept saying, right, 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 over and over.
Nick? I'm not sure that's a good sign.
Neither am I.
Why wouldn't he want your help? I don't get it.
Detective Gumshoe, sir!
What? Find something?
No, sir. Not yet. But there was a call from the precinct. They want to hold an investigation briefing.
A briefing? Right. I'm off. Oh. Sorry, pal. I guess you heard. I gotta go. Any last things you want to ask me about before I head back?
Well, yes. Do you have any information on the victim?
Sorry. They haven't worked up the autopsy report yet. I'm still waiting for it myself. Actually, say, if you get the time, drop by the precinct. We can talk more there, pal.
You're not coming back, Detective?
Probably not, pal.
So what should we do if we have something to talk to you about?
Ah, right. Here, I'll show you how to get to the precinct. Come down and see me anytime.
Directions to the police station received from Detective Gumshoe. Oh, hey, Detective Gumshoe.
What?
We'd like to take a look around in the park. Can we walk around?
Yeah, no problem, pal. You got my permission.
You know, Nick, I think there's something to be said for talking to people when they're busy.
Yeah, they don't have time to think about not giving you information.
Right! Now let's get investigating!
I hear birds. Bird. I feel winter's chill from the banned leaf trees today. Oh god, look at this aspiring poet.
What is it about winter that turns people to...
Kind of stepped on my joke there, man.
I don't know, but my toes are starting to feel numb.
Yes, my poetry has that effect on some people. If I learned anything from the murder of Sonic the Hedgehog, it's that you should always check the trash cans. But apparently in this case, there's nothing there. The sign says Gord Lake Nature Park. This place is full of families picnicking on the weekend.
But no waterfall.
Not many picnickers come here for spiritual training, Maya. Alright, shall we have a look around inside then?
Wowzers! This is Gord Lake?
Yep. I'm not sure it warrants a wowzers, though.
Probably not. But hey, look at that snack stand!
Samurai dogs?
I want a samurai dog! Please? I bet they're great!
With a name like Samurai Dog, how could they not be?
They're a little behind the times, though. The kids are all into the Pink Princess now. I mean, like, you know.
Nope.
Wow, Gord Lake is really big.
Yeah. Say, Nick, why is it called Gourd Lake?
Well, a long time ago, they used to grow gourds here.
Wow, no way! I was sure it was because the lake looked like a gourd when viewed from above. You know, like an hourglass shape?
Well, it is shaped like a gourd, actually, but that's just a coincidence.
Oh, okay.
A hot dog stand. It's closed. The Christmas fringe looks a little half-baked. The banner reads Samurai Dogs. Somebody needs to redecorate. What have we here?
Huh, someone left some poppers here. You know, you pull the spring, and it goes pop.
Yeah, I know the ones. You see them water in New Year's. Which means they're a week early.
Hey, Nick, they might be a clue. Let's take them.
Come on, admit it. You just want to pop them, right?
Was it that obvious?
Poppers. Well, why not? I suppose it couldn't hurt. Huh? Where'd they go?
Into my pocket.
Poppers put in pocket. Try saying that 5 times fast. I've always liked their dynamic. I'd ship them if Maya weren't underage in this game. Yeah, gets a little dangerous there, doesn't it? They do have a nice relationship, though. What else? A lineup of plastic benches. I guess the idea is you buy a dog and eat it here. I doubt anyone would sit here and eat on a day like this. Except maybe Meyer. If she had a samurai dog.
If she had one!
Signpost. Huh. I almost didn't see that signpost. Me too. Left, boat docks. Right, exit. Boat docks is probably worth investigating, isn't it? Ha! I can investigate this trash can. The trash can is empty. I can hear Barry the Quacker just sighing sadly. Oh, at least the place is well maintained. Alright. Boat rental shop? Yep, that sounds like the way to go. It's about the only issue, really, he totally would have gotten with Mia had she not been murdered. Yeah, poor Mia. Well, these games are translated from Japanese. I know Heather said Christmas isn't as much of a big deal in Japan, but the translation has Americanized so many things, the confusion over where these versions are actually set has become a bit of a meme amongst fans. They like to call it Japanifornia. I like that. Yeah, I guess that's a good point. Christmas doesn't exactly get the same treatment in Japan, I suppose, that you see in most Western countries. Yeah, that would make sense. Nick, what is this place? A boat rental shop. Closed for Christmas, it seems.
I guess a murder taking place...
Oh. I guess a murder taking place on one of the boats won't be good for business either.
Boats? I've never ridden on a boat.
Really?
Well, how about we go out on one when the trial is finished? Hey, good idea. You bet.
A small boat rental shop.
Doesn't look like anyone is around.
They're probably closed because it's Christmas. There's more forest off that way. I doubt I'd find any helpful clues in there. There are some boats floating at the dock. Was one of these boats used in the murder, I wonder?
Nick!
Huh?
I changed my mind. I don't really want to go for a boat ride.
Okay. No boat for you, then. Not a whole lot to see here, is there? Alright,
I like it here, Nick. Look, someone's camping.
Maybe they're the witness. They got guts camping at the scene of a murder.
Hey, Nick. If they were camping here last night, they might know something about the murder.
That's true. Good call, Maya. Let's go talk to them. This SUV has seen better days. It's dented all over. I can't believe anyone would drive their car down here. Sign says no camping. Funny place to pick to pitch your tent.
Wait, what if the sign said no setting tents on fire?
I don't think they have signs like that.
Oh.
Maya's fun.
Hey, Nick!
What, don't tell me you're hungry again.
No. I was just wondering, why are camping pots and pans made of aluminium?
They didn't talk about that in any of the lore books.
So there's no law saying they have to be made out of aluminium, then.
I'm not having this conversation. There's food and some magazines on the sheet. It takes a pretty tough skin to camp in this cold. Trees grow quite thick here. Further back, the trees fade into the shadow where the sunlight can't reach them. Oh, cute. Ah. I see what's going on here. This guy's hoping to get a photo of Gordy. This camera has a mic and some sort of attachment. It must take pictures when triggered by a noise.
Wow, cool. Let's try it out. Hi, I'm Nick. Maybe I'm not saying it loud enough. Hey, I'm Nick. Huh. Nick, will you stop that? Maybe it's broken? Don't kick it.
Maybe it isn't set to respond to voices.
Well, what then? These things?
The party poppers? Oh god. Yep. That happened.
Well, it responded.
Yah! Hey you, get your hands off of that! Eek! What in the Sam Hill? Look what you done now! There goes a whole roll of film!
What? Huh? Sorry.
Sorry tonight, but I don't pay my bills! Y'all know how much it costs or a roll of that film costs?
I'll pay you back.
What were y'all thinking setting off a party popper in a place like this?
Well, what?
Don't try to play stupid with me just because you think I'm some country bumpkin. Yeah, I know who you old Yanks think.
Okay, so it sounds like this is supposed to be America.
I say those Southern folks talk with that exaggerated drawl, why they must be dumb. Let me tell you, just because I might be dumb don't mean we all are. Nick, help? And who are you now? Her chaperone?
No. Rather, we're sort of friends?
Just figure out what y'all are gonna say and say it for bejesus' sake. God, I'd rather sit through one of Papa's drawls and listen to you stutter all day.
Oh boy. I guess we should pay her for the film.
Watch it!
Yes, ma'am.
On second thought, I'll pay later. I'm really sorry. What?
Can't you see I'm changing the film on my camera here? Someone, I'm not naming any names, but someone used up a whole roll!
Sorry.
That didn't work. Wonder if I have anything to show her that would get her attention. I don't think so. I think I got to see attorney badge.
What? Can't you see I'm changing the film on my camera here?
Oh, yeah. Alright. this is my badge.
Huh? What badge is supposed to be all shiny and impressive? You a cop or something?
I'm a lawyer.
What? Y'all ain't gonna try and pull one of them lawsuits on me over that film now. Cause I'll have y'all know I'm a fighter and I wrestled meaner looking things than you.
No, that's not it at all. Well, we're here investigating a murder that took place here, on the lake.
A murder? Sounds cool!
God.
Why didn't you all say that in the first place? Go ahead, ask me anything you like.
Finally, some cooperation.
You two, y'all can come out of hiding now. I won't bite.
Hard.
Come to think of it, where did Mike get to?
Sorry. I was feeling a little overwhelmed. The culture gap and all. Never you mind, honey. I can talk Yank for you if you... If it pleases you. Thanks. I think I'll be okay. Great then. I'm Lotta. Lotta Hart, but y'all can call me Lotta.
Lotta something.
Am I right, boys? I'm here photographing meteor showers for a research project. Mighty pleased to meet ya.
I feel like I've gone into more old-timey prospector than woman from the South, but I'm not a talented voice actor. That's the best I've got. Alright.
So what is it you do, Lotta?
Huh? Me? Y'all don't really want to know that, do ya? Actually, I'm a research student at Country U, right in the heart of the heartland.
Wow, neat. Nick, she's a research student at a university. Country U.
So I hear.
So when did you come up here?
Let me see. I guess it was about 3 days ago.
What are you photographing?
Didn't I tell you all that already? Meteors. Yep. Meteor showers.
Falling stars? Then why does she need a microphone on a camera?
I don't think she's being truthful.
Oh yeah.
When was that murder anyway?
I ain't seen much television lately.
It happened late in the night on Christmas Eve.
That's so. Christmas Eve? A man on a boat was shot.
Did you see anything? Well, let me see. A boat, you say? I reckon I might have seen one. Not sure, though. Y'all gotta remember, I've been watching this here lake for a good 3 days now. I seen enough boats to choke a mule. Kinda hard to remember which I seen when.
That's quite a camera you have there.
Y'all better know it. It's German-made, a genuine Solingen.
Isn't that where they make knives?
So what's that device you have stuck to the camera?
Huh? Device?
Your camera went off all by itself when I fired my party popper.
Oh, that mic triggers the shutter whenever it detects certain sounds. It's programmed to pick up loud noises right now.
Programmable camera. Neat!
Lotta's camera added to the court record. Set to automatically take a picture when a loud noise is detected. Faces the lake. Okay. Cool. Now, this camera is rigged to respond to noise, but it only responds to loud noises, like a party popper. So she is trespassing here. Very fishy. Feel like there's something I'm missing here. Feel like there should be more information I can get here. Lotta?
Yeah?
So, your camera, it triggers on loud explosion noises? Yup. Actually, the victim in the case we're researching, he was shot with a pistol.
A pistol?
Right. Now, wouldn't a gunshot make a similar noise to our party popper?
I guess it would.
Your camera didn't get a picture of the murder, did it?
Hey! Y'all are pretty bright.
Huh?
I see what you're saying. Tell you what, I'll have a look-see at my film.
It would have been a photo taken late last night.
I checked them once, don't remember if there was anything on them, though.
But what if I got some?
I could be a witness to a genuine murder! Yeehaw! I'll go check that film. Y'all come back now, you hear?
Ugh. Oh, the country. It hurts me.
She went inside her SUV. I guess we should come back later.
Alright. Do you think that's enough time? Guess not. Alright, where else? I think we've been in everywhere now. Oh, well, we haven't been down to Gumshoe's office yet.
I guess Detective Gumshoe is still in that meeting.
Hey! Thanks for coming down, pal.
Detective Gumshoe!
We just finished a meeting, for better or for worse.
I get the feeling we're in for some bad news. So, how did the meeting go?
I can't tell you, pal. You're a lawyer.
True.
You know, I don't know what to believe anymore. Sure, Mr. Edgeworth's human like you or me. Still, I get the feeling that if you'd done something wrong, he wouldn't go hiding it. That's just the kind of guy he is. Why can't anyone else see that?
So they think that Mr. Edgeworth did it?
Well, the trial's starting tomorrow, as scheduled.
I see.
Hey, in the end you did tell us about the meeting.
Don't go telling anyone else, pal.
Yes, sir.
Then, do me a favor. Stand by Mr. Edgeworth. He needs help, and you're the ones to help him. I'm sure he's got some reason why he won't talk to us.
Thanks, Detective Gumshoe.
Do you know anything about the victim yet?
No, still can't ID him.
Has Mr. Edgeworth said anything?
Not a word.
Detective Gumshoe, how come you trust Mr. Edgeworth so much?
Well, I think that was obvious. We got a strong working relationship, us two. We trust each other, and that's how it works.
A working relationship?
See, Mr. Edgeworth always gets his defendants declared guilty. Every time.
Not every time.
Yeah, his methods might be a little extreme at times. But there's a reason. He trusts our investigation, see? He trusts us to get the right man. That's why I work extra hard, pal. We got to earn that trust he places in us.
I see.
Mr. Edgeworth is a man you can trust. And you have my word on that.
Not sure I agree with that, but okay. I was wondering, did you ever get that autopsy report?
Oh, that? Yeah, I made a copy for you.
Autopsy report added to the court record. Time of death, sometime on the 24th or 25th. Cause, one bullet shot to the heart. And you're to blame, you give a bad name.
Thank you. Nick?
Huh?
Can you show me that photo of the victim? That face!
Someone you know?
I don't know. I just have this feeling that I met him somewhere a long time ago.
I wonder if he's related to the case with Maya and Mia's mother. Alright. These are the detectives' desks. There are computers and files on each one. Funny, they're a lot tidier than I expect. I guess the detectives don't spend a lot of time at their desks. That must be one of the detectives. He's mumbling something to himself.
Alright, hands against the wall, oh yeah. Don't even think about escaping. I got eyes in the back of my head.
He must be doing image training for arrests. This must be the chief of the detectives here. He's glued to his computer screen.
What? Gord Lake? Gordy sided? I don't believe it!
Shouldn't you be reading something more important? A poster of a female police officer. Wait, no, that's the latest Babes in Uniform calendar. My bad. Okay. Hey, is that the police department's mascot?
That's the Blue Badger. It was my idea. I made it. It's my mascot.
I see. How nice.
I'll get him assigned mascot in the Criminal Affairs Department if it's the last thing I do.
Good luck.
Why not?
Sorry, I'm drawing a blank right now.
Okay. Alright, let's see if Lotta is ready for us yet. That's a good sign.
Hey, y'all! Lotta! Wait up a sec! We got Bingo! Bingo? My automatic camera took two pictures last night. Hey! This is them. Take a look. Wait. See? See? He's shooting him with that pistol!
It looks like that, yes. But you can't really tell who that is shooting.
Yeah, well, there was enough fog out there last night to strangle a bullfrog.
Is that how fog works?
But, you know, seeing these photos reminded me of something.
What?
I saw the murder happen. I'm a witness.
What? Are you serious?
Of course.
How do you forget? Never mind.
Y'all reckon I should tell the cops?
I reckon not.
What's that? Now don't y'all think y'all can pull one over on me just cause you speak the lingo. I know enough to know that when you see a murder, you best tell the cops. It's my obligation as a citizen. Hey, so I'm off to talk to the cops. Y'all can have this photo. Later.
Wait. Lotta?
What? Can't y'all see I'm kinda busy?
Tell us what you saw too, please.
Nice try, honey, but I wasn't born yesterday. I'm a witness and that means I'm on the side of justice. And that means the cops.
No comment.
I'd sooner eat the south side of a northbound skunk than tell you.
Lotta, don't let it get your skibbies in a bunch. Friends today, enemies tomorrow. Or was that the other way around? No matter, I'm gone.
Hey, may they let me do some testifying. Hot darn!
She left. Well, that's one more witness. What do we do now, Nick?
Well, if she saw something, there's not much we can do about it. The question is, what exactly did she see? I guess we'll find out in the trial tomorrow. Wake photo added to the court record. Taken automatically on 12:25 at 12:15 a.m.
Okay. Now what?
Looks like the police have given up their interviewing.
Hey! Oh god!
Ah! Nick? I think Santa's mad at you!
Long time no see, Nick.
Phoenix knows Santa?
Nick? You know Santa? Wow! Nick and Saint Nick! Hey, I see the connection.
No, it means you saw something that may help prove who the killer is, whether it's Edgeworth or not. That's literally it. Indeed. Don't be ridiculous. Dude, it's me. Oh, is this, from our previous trial?
Larry!
That's right, Larry Butts, not Harry Butts.
What are you doing here?
Isn't it obvious? Working my day job. I sell samurai dogs. Want one? Gotta get money for dates, you know. My girl Kiyase deserves the best.
Kiyase?
Not another model, I hope. Oh, Kiyase's a fine, fine woman, Nick. It was her idea that I wear this costume. She was all,
you go, girlfriend!
You know, she bought this costume for me. That's great, Larry.
Wow, a Santa costume. She must be really nice.
Whoa, cute. Nick, who's she? She's not your...
Not my what? No,
she's not.
I'm his partner, Maya Faye. I'm the little sister.
Sister? Wow, Nick, must be tough. Working 9 to 5, having to take care of a little sister.
No, I'm not Nick's sister. I'm my older sister's little sister. And honestly, you know, when you think about it,
Aren't we all our older sister's little sisters? That's deep. Or I'm talking about this. Huh, sounds great. Don't worry, Maya, he's not listening.
Alright, what do you know, Mr. Butts?
Hey, Larry. There was a murder here last night. And since you work here, have you heard anything? Nick, you're wasting your time. Last night was Christmas Eve. He was with Kianse, obviously. He wouldn't have been standing out here in the cold.
Ugh.
Hmm?
I think what you just said caught him off guard, Maya.
No, it's just Kianse's not in town right now. She's in Hawaii on a photo shoot.
A model. I knew it.
Well, anyway, there was a murder here on the lake. The trial's tomorrow.
Huh.
Neat.
The defendant's Edgeworth. Miles Edgeworth.
Nick? Why would Larry know Edgeworth?
Whoa, Nick! You don't mean that Miles Edgeworth? Oh, what, Edgy?
Yeah, he's a murder suspect.
Whoa, murder?
Huh? You know Mr. Edgeworth, Larry?
Yeah, of course. Edgy was in the same class as us in grade school.
What?
I saw that one coming, honestly.
So, Mr. Edgeworth was your classmate, Larry?
Yeah, Nick, him and I used to hang out all the time.
Wow, I never knew.
Don't get me wrong, he's always been kind of a stick in the mud. Studying all the time, trying to be like father.
Like his father?
Yeah, Edgy's pop was a famous defense lawyer back in the day. No, Miles Edgeworth the librarian.
Freaking Larry, man.
Yeah, freaking Larry, man.
Wow. Wait, you said defense lawyer.
Yeah.
Wait a second, but Miss Edgeworth is a prosecuting attorney.
What? Edgy's got a proboscis on his knee? Frickin' Larry, man.
No, he's a prosecuting attorney. That's like the total opposite of a defense lawyer.
Huh. Go figure. He always used to talk about defending the weak who were unable to defend themselves. Man, he used to go on and on about man's duty to society and all that. What a bore. I wonder what changed his mind, though. Do you know Nick?
Nick? Tell me about the dogs.
Uh-huh. Oh, you mean the samurai dogs?
Why are they samurai dogs? I mean, they kind of look gourd-shaped.
Oh, well, originally they were gourd dogs. You know, like guard dogs.
Ouch.
The samurai thing was Kianse's idea. Oh, she's my woman, you know. She was a change of name and you go, girlfriend.
It's actually a spinoff with Edgeworth that answers this.
Yeah, I think I'd heard about the Edgeworth game. Might have to look into that at some point. She made me that banner. Man, the kids can't get enough of those samurai dogs.
Something about that just seems wrong.
Oh, and guess what? We're getting a ton of customers here at the lake, what with the big news.
The big news?
Yeah, Gordy.
Gordy? What's Gordy?
Huh? You mean you don't know? It's here, in this very lake. A giant mysterious monster, Gordy.
A monster?
Yeah. Check it out. This is an article from yesterday's newspaper. There's a photo.
Wow, it's really real. Nick, a monster? A real monster? Come on. Please, tell me, does that not look like guy sticking his hand out of the water?
Yeah, it's probably just a log or something, right? Hey, there's a quote here from the person who took the photo. What's this? I set the camera to automatic, and when we got into the frame, I heard a loud bang, like an explosion, followed by the sound of something slipping into the water.
I wish I could have seen it.
Why would there be a sound like an So, that was the murder taking place, I guess? Larry, could I borrow this article for me?
Sure, no problem. That'll be $1 million.
$1 million?
Grow up, Larry.
Gordy article added to the court report. Article about a monster sighted at Gord Lake.
Alright. Let's get out of here before the stupidity becomes contagious. Alright. Well, we've spoken to people and examined things. Maybe we'll be able to talk to Miles now. Edra, this is really hard for me to ask. But you didn't do it, right? Right?
Think what you will. I have only one request.
Huh?
Stay out of this case.
Oops. Bit late for that.
Why? But Nick is trying to help you.
I know that. But I don't want your help, okay?
Why not?
Look, just go away and leave me alone.
Nick, Mr. Edgeworth did it, didn't he?
Maya, let's go investigate elsewhere.
But Nick!
Maybe we can catch water at the police department?
Not a gumshoe in sight.
If you're looking for Detective Gumshoe, he's in the questioning room. Apparently an important witness turned up. He'll be in there in a while.
Light of heart. It has to be.
Uh-oh.
Your voice for Edgeworth is actually pretty close to the dub of the anime.
Oh, well that's great.
What is it?
Oh, nothing. Just something's been bothering me. Could you show me that autopsy report once more? Hey, I remember now. This guy. He's a lawyer that was at the office Mia worked at. I met him once when I went there to hang out with Sis.
That office? Wait. You mean Grossberg's office?
Right, that guy.
That was the last name I expected to come up. Maybe I should go talk to him, for old time's sake. Okay. I guess we got a new lead. that old familiar clearing at the throat.
Aha! You're Mia's something, are you not? I was her understudy, yes. Phoenix Wright.
Aha! And you, your name is something too, are you not?
Her little sister, yes.
You've grown. You've come to look a lot like your sister, you know. It takes me back. Ah, the days of my youth. Like the scent of fresh linen. You see?
Mr. Grossberg, sir?
Hmm? Ah, yes. I beg your pardon. Of course you came here to discuss something. What is it, then? Something the matter?
There was a murder last night.
A murder?
You haven't heard?
Just got up, you see.
Well, Miles Edgeworth shot someone with a pistol.
Edgeworth? What? Who did he shoot?
Well, the identity of the victim is still unknown.
This is terrible news indeed.
I guess he hadn't heard anything. Mr. Grossberg, whatever happened to that painting?
Oh, yes. I do not think it shall ever be coming back home to this office. I can't exactly claim it is stolen. I suppose it's my just desserts. Old, bitter desserts.
Let's try presenting.
Hmm? Strange. I feel as though I've seen this man somewhere before. Ah!
Did you remember?
He was a lawyer, here, in my office. That's Hammond, Robert Hammond.
Mr. Hammond?
Well, hello there to you too, Peaches. How are you doing tonight? Or today, whatever time of day it is we're in your part of the world.
And you say this is the man Miles Edgeworth shot?
Pretty bored. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. I will do my best to keep you entertained.
Who is this Hammond guy anyway?
Mr. Hammond. He was a defense attorney in that case.
That case?
Yes, the DL6 incident.
DL6? Why does that sound so familiar?
Oh, well, happy birthday, Peaches. I hope you have a great day.
Perhaps you remember?
I'm sure someone mentioned it during the trial for Mia's murder. Was that the murder case her mother was involved with?
That was the incident where the police were so at a loss they used it.
It was Mia's mother.
Wait, you don't mean... Was that medium my mother?
Yes, my dear. The spirit medium, Misty Faye... Your mother contacted the spirit of the victim. But the case was a loss. No conviction was made. The DL6 incident, yes, happened 15 years ago. A very strange case indeed.
They never caught the criminal, right?
Correct. Misty Faye used her powers to talk to the spirits of the late victim. Her testimony led to charges being laid against one man. But Mr. Hammond won the case, and the suspect was declared innocent.
And the police blamed my mother, calling her a fraud. You were the one who helped her out then, right, Mr. Grossberg?
Yes. Yes, quite.
Thank you.
No, please, don't mention it.
DL6. Never thought I'd hear that name again.
But wait... What does that case have anything to do with Mr. Edgeworth?
It has everything to do with Mr. Edgeworth, my dear. The victim in the DL6 incident was none other than his father, Gregory Edgeworth.
Oh, interesting. That's a twist I didn't see coming.
What? His father?
If you want to know more, you should ask him yourself. Show him this. I'm sure he'll talk to you.
Wait, this is a photograph of my mother.
Misty Faye's photo adds to the court record. An old photograph. DL6 incident, Exhibit A, is written on the back. Alright. If we can get Miles to actually talk, that'd be a big help.
What's this? I was hoping you'd gotten my message the first time.
Edgeworth, what about your defense?
It's no concern of yours.
Guess he hasn't found anyone yet.
Oh.
Edgeworth?
It's only been a matter of hours since you last visited. Yet you've made incredible progress in your investigation. I'll admit it, I'm impressed, right? You were always single-minded in your work, though. Once you start on something, you always see it through, don't you?
About the DL6 episode.
Right. DL6. I didn't want you to find out about it. That is why I refused your offer to defend me.
The backstory of the Fae family and their spirit channeling rituals is a big plot point in multiple cases in the second and third games. This case is about to get crazy, but it has nothing on those games' finales. But I'm not a dick, no spoilers here. Thank you for not being a dick. As Cassie Lang would say, it is never too late to not be a dick.
I'm sorry if it sounded like I thought you weren't up to the job.
Wow. That was actually almost something nice he said to us.
I just wanted to keep you away from DL6.
So, do you still think it would have been better for me to stay away?
I don't know. But I see no point in hiding anything from you now. Very well. Ask whatever you like, and I will answer to the best of my ability.
This is Nate, getting character development for this guy.
The DL6 incident was when my father died. Right before my eyes.
That's rough.
He was shot and killed, and I saw it all. My memories from that time are foggy. I suppose it's a self-defense mechanism. In any case, a suspect was arrested. A man. Pretty clear he was the only one who could have killed my father. The spirit medium they used to talk to my late father said the same thing. It was an attorney by the name of Robert Hammond that cleared the suspect's name.
And Hammond is the victim in the Gordwijk murder?
Correct.
That spirit medium. That was my mom.
What? You mean your... Strange. I thought that terrible incident was about to end. And now... this.
About to end.
The DL6 incident happened 15 years ago. 15 years ago on December 28.
December 28?
The statute of limitations on the case runs out in 3 days.
What?
Nick, what does that mean?
When a case's statute of limitations runs out, legally, the case never happened.
3 days from now, DL6 will be closed. Forever.
Well, to clarify Dom's statement, this case is the original finale. This game, depending on which version you have. You may unlock a DLC case when you reach the end of this one, which is okay, but not my favorite. It introduces a character who becomes prominent in the second trilogy. Okay. Well, it'll be interesting to see if it's included in this bundle up, I guess.
Was your father a lawyer?
He was. Gregory Edgeworth. He was quite famous at the time, apparently.
So you were sort of trying to follow in his footsteps?
I'd rather not talk about it.
What happened to the suspect? The one who got off innocent?
I don't know. He disappeared from public view. Nobody knows where to. If he's still alive, he'd be about 50 years old now.
I guess I can understand why he'd go into hiding. It'd be hard to live a normal life after being a murder suspect in such a big case.
Interesting.
What's that? I'm not in the mood for idle banter, right? Who would have thought there'd be a photo?
Edrith, did you shoot him?
What do you think, right?
I don't think you're the kind to point a gun at anyone, no.
So you didn't shoot him?
No, I didn't. It wasn't me. Right. It pains me to ask you this now.
I know, you want us to defend you.
Yes. Will you?
Of course we will. Who would have guessed this day would come?
Not me.
This is my chance to finally pay you back.
Pay him back?
Pay me back? For what? I don't remember ever doing anything for you.
Never mind. I guess you don't really need to know.
Huh. My letter of request. Please give it to Detective Gumshoe.
Document proving Edward's request for an attorney. Well, I guess we should...
Huh? What's that?
Earthquake! Nick, it's a big one! What? It's coming down. Whew, that was scary.
Huh?
Where's Edgeworth? There! He's on the floor at a ball, shivering. I guess he doesn't do so well with earthquakes.
I've heard of running, but curling up in a ball?
Well, I guess we're done. Mr. Edgeworth doesn't seem like he's going to stand up anytime soon. Let's go, Nick.
Right. We have to give Edgeworth's letter of request to Detective Gumshoe.
What's going on here?
Eek!
What's wrong, Detective?
This wild lady comes in here just a while ago. Said she came to talk to y'all after hearing what Mr. Wright had to say. What's this all about, pal?
What a hot.
Why are you going around finding more witnesses? You want to You want to give Mr. Edgeworth a death sentence, pal?
No, not at all. Just, I mean, she did say something. There's nothing I can do about that. I can't go around covering up evidence.
You're trying to say something about the way I do my job.
I'm trying to say something about the way all police do their job. No, sir. Look what I got.
Hey, you did it, pal. Glad I waited till the last minute to file those papers. I'll rip them up and start new ones for you.
Thanks, Detective. Well, see you in court tomorrow, then.
Good luck, pal. Hey. You guys feel that earthquake a little while back? I was worried.
Worried? We're fine. I've lived out here my whole life. I'm pretty used to them by now. What, do they live in California or something?
Oh, I wasn't worried about you.
Or maybe it is Japan.
I was worried about Mr. Edgeworth.
Oh, right. He did seem to overreact a little now that you mention it.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised. It was a pretty big quake. I'm gonna go check on him. You two go eat and get your rest for tomorrow's trial. Later!
I wonder what it is with Mr. Edgeworth and earthquakes.
I wonder. He was never that scared of them when he was in school. Then again, I only really got to know him in fourth grade.
transferred to another school after that. I wonder what happened to Edgeworth. Mysterious. Well, yes. Yes, I will. Alright. Oh, no. We've already done it. Alright. Let's see how the first day of the trial goes. Karma?
That's right. Manfred von Karma. He's the best prosecutor there is. He hasn't lost a case in his 40-year career. He is a god of prosecution, right? A god!
Voice acting is hard. Not a single case?
He'll do anything to get a guilty verdict. Anything.
Sounds like someone else I know, Edgeworth.
You don't understand. I mean, he'll really do anything. Manfred von Karma is a man to be feared.
That's quite a claim coming from someone who forges evidence.
He taught me what it really means to prosecute.
What?
Just picture a prosecutor as vicious as me, multiplied by a factor of 10.
Ah, so we've reached the final boss then.
So was he your teacher then, Mr. Edgeworth?
Something like that.
Now he's trying to get you found guilty? What a creep! Oh, wait. Maybe he's planning on losing on purpose to help you out.
Not a chance. He hasn't lost once in 40 years. 40 years! He's as ruthless as me, times 20.
That's pretty ruthless.
Like I said, he's a god among prosecutors.
I guess that's something like Mia was to me. Speaking of Mia... Maya?
Uh-huh?
We could really be using Mia's help right now, don't you think?
Oh...
I
can't. Sorry, I tried. I really tried, but I couldn't reach.
You couldn't reach?
I think it's because I haven't been training. My powers are weak again.
Oh man, what bad timing.
I'm really sorry. I'll try my best.
I hope so.
What are you whispering about?
It's nothing. Well, it's time. Let's head in.
That's no good. Lost my headphones cord. There we go.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Miles Edgeworth.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Mr. Von Karma, is the prosecution ready?
Fool. You seriously think that I would stand here, were I not completely prepared?
Is it just me, or does this guy look like a vampire? He's scary.
Right, my apologies.
He's even got the judge scared.
Very well, your opening statement, please.
Decisive evidence. A decisive witness. What else could possibly be required?
Nothing, of course. That should be fine. The prosecution may call its first witness.
What's with this guy? Is he royalty or something?
How am I supposed to fight against this?
I call the detective in charge of this case, Detective Dick Gumshoe.
I mean, there is a private dick joke I could use here, but,
okay, Gumshoe's first. Let's see how this goes. Describe the incident. Now! Yes, sir!
Detective Gumshoe looks nervous.
Please take a look at the map. The murder happened late Christmas Eve, around midnight. There was one boat in the very middle of the... That does not look in the very middle of the lake. There were two men on the boat. Now, there happened to be a woman camping here on the edge of the lake. At 12:10 a.m., she heard two pistol shots. Then the boat started to move. It went towards a boat rental shop.
Overhead map added to the court record.
Testify to the court about the arrest. Now.
Wait, Mr. Von Karma.
Yes?
Actually, I'm the one that's supposed to be handling these proceedings.
Oh god. Wrong. There is only one thing you need to do here. You will slam down your gavel and say the word guilty. That is your role.
Yes, of course. You're quite right.
Wow, this guy's really intimidated.
No, he's not! A man called into the station around 30 minutes after midnight. We headed to the scene of the crime as fast as we could. That's where we found Mr. Edgeworth. Now, I didn't suspect him of anything at all. But the next morning, a body was found in the lake. So we had to arrest Mr. Edgeworth.
I see. Very well.
Begin your cross-examination, attorney. Now.
Mr. Scary Vampire Man, in this household, we use a little word called please.
Alright. What are the buttons? It's been a while.
Present and press.
You received a call from a man.
Or as a nostalgia creek would put it,
man.
Yep. But you said there was a woman camping there. She was the one who heard the two gunshots, right?
Oh god. That's a scary voice. That woman and the man who were called in the report are two different people, obviously.
Different people?
There were two witnesses. Their testimonies were quite similar, however. Today I've summoned the woman who was camping.
The woman who was camping. What a heart.
What happened next, Detective?
How long was it between receiving the report and your arrival at the lake?
Well, I'd say it was about 3 minutes.
That's pretty fast.
Our motto for the month is, get there quick. Detective. You will refrain from casually revealing department secrets.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
I look forward to your next year's salary review. So much to look forward to these days. This is no time for detective daydreaming. Continue. Yes, sir.
What was Miss Edgeworth like when you saw him then?
Well, from what I saw, he looked pretty relaxed. Not like a murderer at all, really. Detective, the court requires the facts, not your opinion. How many years have you been on the force? Facts only, Detective. Hard, cold, objective facts. Yes, sir.
Man, he's got his share of objections.
Why didn't you think he was suspicious?
You should know. We have a deep, trusting relationship with the prosecutors.
Detective, the court isn't interested in your musings. Deep, trusting poppycock. I've never heard so many flippant comments from an active detective on the force.
Detective Gumshoe doesn't look so good.
Continue now.
Did you find any clues on the body?
A single bullet was recovered from the body. He was shot through the heart, fatally.
Judge, here's the bullet. It didn't strike bone, so its shape is well preserved.
Very well, the court accepts this bullet into evidence.
Bullet found the victim's body, fired from a 22 caliber pistol.
So we had to arrest Mr. Edgeworth.
Why is that?
Well, we found the murder weapon in the boat.
The murder weapon?
A pistol.
Detective Gumshoe, that is a vital piece of information. Please revise your testimony.
Alright. So sorry, Your Honor. The murder weapon we found in the boat was decisive evidence.
What about the pistol made it decisive evidence?
Tisk, tisk, tisk.
He has the same evil laugh as Edgeworth.
There were fingerprints on the pistol found in the boat. They were clear prints from Mr. Edgeworth's right hand.
That's not good. What?
Order! Order! So Mr. Edgeworth's fingerprints were found on the murder weapon?
Yes, Your Honor. Judge, this is the weapon in question.
Accepted into evidence?
A murder weapon, 22 caliber, fired 3 times, bears prints from Edgeworth's right hand. 3 times? But they only heard 2 shots. That's interesting.
Members of the court, we now have the pistol used in the murder, and the bullet found in the body. Detective?
Yes, sir.
Was the bullet found in the body fired from this pistol?
Yes, the ballistic markings on the mullet match the pistol.
Hey, Nick! What does he mean, ballistic markings?
Shocking. To imagine someone here does not know something as basic as ballistic markings.
Nick, he's glaring at me.
Very well, I'll explain.
Actually, Judge,
you do it.
Me? Ballistic markings are like the fingerprints of a gun. The barrel leaves distinctive marks on each bullet it fires. You can examine these ballistic fingerprints to see which gun fired the shot. It's quite accurate.
Indeed. This leads to one inevitable conclusion. The bullet found in the victim's heart was, without a doubt, fired from this pistol. This pistol, which, as you may recall, was covered with the defendant's own fingerprints.
Order! Order!
This is bad. This makes it look like Edgeworth did it. Well, Judge?
I'd say it's almost decisive, yes. Honestly, I could declare a verdict at this point. However...
You wish to hear the witness speak, no doubt. Very well. I am somewhat fatigued, and so I will take a brief break. I will call my witness after the recess, which will last 10 minutes.
I'm
sure he needs to step out for a pint of blood.
Judge.
Yes?
What are you doing? A 10-minute recess. Now.
But wait, I...
Just bang your flimsy gavel and get on with it, man.
Yes. This court will take a 10-minute recess.
Who's running this court anyway?
Boxing.
Edward, what's going on here?
Your fingerprints were on the murder weapon.
And that foggy photo makes one thing clear. The only one who could have shot that man was the person in the photo.
True.
Was that you in the boat?
Yes, it was me.
What?
But you must believe me, I didn't shoot him.
Then who did?
I don't know.
You don't know? Weren't you right there?
I heard a gunshot from very close by. Then the other man fell from the boat. I can't say why, but I thought at the time that he had shot himself.
You mean it was a suicide?
That's the only explanation I can come up with.
Huh. How am I going to convince anyone of that? Say, Maya?
Huh? What?
Any progress with Mia?
Oh, sorry. It's no good.
Ugh. I know. I'm no good for anything, am I, Nick?
If I can't call my sister, I might as well not be here, right?
Well, there's no need to be rude about it. No, I need you here. I can see you're always trying to help out. Even if you don't actually help, it's the thought that counts, right?
It's okay, Nick. You don't have to make me feel better. I don't know anything about trials or defense. What's more, I'm a spirit medium who can't even contact spirits.
Now, everyone has their off days.
I mean, I've just been getting lucky lately. But
you never know when my luck is going to run out.
Really?
Whoa, right? Don't jinx this case any more than it already is. It's bad for my heart.
Oh, sorry. Whoops.
Court is back in session. Mr. Von Karma, call your witness.
Yes. Will Ms. Lotterhart take the stand?
Oh, I wanted to see who the other witness was.
Lotterhart, you are a research student at a university?
That I am!
I know the prospect of voice doesn't really fit her, but the accent, you know, it's the best I got.
Good. Begin by telling us what you saw the night of the incident. And don't add anything trivial or subjective. Understand?
Y'all need to learn some manners.
Understand?
Yeah, I understand. I understand.
Very well. Your testimony, please.
It was Christmas Eve, just after midnight, I reckon. I was in my car. I heard this bang come up from the lake. When I looked out the window, I saw two gents in a boat. Then there was another bang. There wasn't nary thing on the lake but that boat.
Enough.
Huh?
Judge. She happened to take a photo of the incident. This is that photo. Accept it as evidence.
Well, this is a surprise.
It looks like the very moment of the murder.
Order! I will remove people from this courtroom if I do not have the order immediately.
As the witness testified, she looked at the lake when she heard the shot. There were no other boats on that lake. So the man in the boat with the victim must have been the victim who shot him. Must have been the one who shot him. Yes, it was the defendant, Miles Edgeworth.
Order!
Well, Judge,
the evidence is decisive. I have very little doubt about this case. Very well, this court finds the defendant.
Thank you. Wait, Your Honor, I haven't cross-examined the witness yet. A cross-examination? We have photographic proof. What question can there possibly be? This photo is worth 1,000 words, and they all read guilty. That's one word. You lose. Or, do you claim to have found a contradiction in her testimony? Very well. If you have to, you may cross-examine the witness. You will only flounder and ask meaningless questions. Hey, flandering and asking meaningless questions is what I do best, man. You will fail to find anything. And then I will have you held in contempt of court.
Nick? Contempt? Contempt of court, you know? I guess I understand. Well, what are you going to do? Do you really think there was a contradiction with the facts in her testimony?
I think there was. I think I noticed one little thing. Wow, I'm impressed, Nick. I didn't notice anything.
Right, let's take him on.
Yeah. I got a bad feeling about this. I understand. I will cross-examine a witness. Tisk, tisk, tisk. Very well.
I pray for your sake this isn't a waste of time.
Okay, so she did say 2 shots were fired and then a 3rd shot. So where this... And the gun did have 3 bullets missing.
Just after midnight, you say? In other words, it was no longer Christmas Eve, but...
I don't think you're going to... I think you're going to have to do a little better than that, my friend.
Huh? Oh, yeah, well, yes. I know you want to find contradictions, but really...
I hope your next contradiction is a little more relevant to the trial. Witness, continue your testimony.
Why were you camping there anyway? I'm a research student at my university. I was taking pictures to use in my research.
What research? This all sounds suspicious.
Ms. Hart, could you be more specific about your research?
What does a witness's motive in camping by the lake have to do with this case? The answer is nothing. I object to this line of questioning.
Objection, sister.
The judge isn't gonna let that one go, is he?
Wait now, I'm the one who says that!
Well then, say it already.
Objection sustained.
Thanks for nothing, Your Honor.
So you weren't looking at the lake at that time?
Nope. I looked after I heard that noise.
She said that already. I asked you to find contradictions, not leisurely chat with the witness.
Ugh.
Could
Could you clearly see the two men?
Just look at the picture. Clear enough for you?
Uh-oh. Wait a second. I wasn't asking you about the photo. I was asking if you saw the two men.
Yeah, well, of course.
The witness has testified that she saw them. There's also a photo. You'd best look elsewhere for your precious contradictions. He jumped in quick. He's hiding something.
Were you watching the very moment the shot rang out?
Well, yeah, sure.
You're asking meaningless questions. Meaningless. Contradictions, Mr. Wright, not meaningless babble.
Von Karma, I think I hate you. He's trying to keep me from talking to the witness. To what end?
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, sure as a country gal can be.
That sounds pretty sure. How come you're so sure?
Well, heck, I scanned the whole lake.
Scan the whole lake? Oh, it sounds like she was more interested in the lake than the boat. Miss Hart, you... Oh, for fuck's sakes.
Mr. Wright, the witness has answered the question in full. No need for further questions. Objection sustained.
That's what I'm...
Sustained.
Yes, of course.
Oh, great.
Enough. I think we've heard all we need to hear, Mr. Wright. It seems you are unable to find a contradiction in the testimony worth noting.
I think I did. It sounded like she only heard two shots, not three.
But Your Honor... You keep your promise.
Mr. Wright, I am afraid that I will have to penalize any further outbursts by holding you in contempt of court.
And if that happens, you'll have to leave the courtroom immediately. Understood?
Nick? Well, his testimony is fishy, Nick. Real fishy.
I know what you mean. But if I can't say anything, what can I do?
I believe we've covered the evidence sufficiently to make a decision.
Then pass your judgment.
Very well. Mr. Miles Edgeworth, please take the stand. Who was that?
It was me.
Maya?
Is something wrong? Do you need to use the facilities?
No, I do not. What a heart. Your testimony stinks. It's unclear whether you were actually looking at the lake. It's highly doubtful that you actually saw Mr. Edgeworth. Tell us the truth. This is a matter of life or death. Lotta, did you really clearly see Mr. Edgeworth that night? Did you see him fire that pistol?
You will stand down. The court does not acknowledge the defense's outburst.
Answer me, Lotta. What's the big idea? Treat me like some kind of criminal. I saw him. I swear it. I saw Edgeworth.
Enough. Judge, declare the defense in contempt of court.
Yes. Yes, of course. I'm sorry, but you were warned. Guard, escort Mr. Wright out of the courtroom. He is in contempt of court and must leave.
No. No!
Wait! I was the one who made the outburst, Your Honor. Nick is innocent.
What's the difference? All that remains is for the guilty verdict to be declared. Isn't that right, Mr. Phoenix Wright? Wrong. What? Did you hear what Ms. Hart just said? She said she clearly saw Mr. Edgeworth.
That was not in the testimony. That changes her testimony, and I have a right to cross-examine her again.
Order, 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 order.
You're in contempt of court. It's too late for wild claims. Judge, sustain my objection.
I'm sorry, Mr. Von Karma, but I cannot.
Finally, he's grown a pair of balls.
What? Miss Lotterhart has made a new testimony. The defense does have a right to cross-examine her again.
But he's in contempt of court. No, I am. If you're going to arrest someone, arrest me.
Very well. Maya Fey, you will leave the courtroom immediately.
Nick, I did what I could. You have to do the rest. Good luck. Maya.
I care not for this melodrama. Listen well, Mr. Wright. I do not tolerate badgering of my witness.
I'm running out of time. Better find a contradiction in here or else.
Mr. Wright, begin your cross-examination.
I saw it clear as day. The man on the boat was Mr. Edgeworth.
Well, what about the other man? You cannot expect to be allowed to blithely ignore your promise, Mr. Wright. I believe you claimed there was a contradiction in the witness's testimony. Well, find it. If you can.
Mr. Wright, I have to assign you a...
Oh, darn. Damn. That's it? Uh-oh, I don't know if I can find anything in that. But I cannot squander Maya's efforts either. Well, let's see. What's the button for tab? Alright, let's use this photo here. Gotcha. Got you, Miss Hart, finally. What? You got what? Look at this photograph. The photo I took. The very same. There's something I want you to see in this photo. It's quite clearly visible. The fog, Miss Hart. So? This picture was taken with professional, high-quality film, correct? Yet even it could not capture the faces of the men on the boat. Yet you claim you saw Mr. Edgeworth. How? What? What?
Mr. Wright has a point.
That's why I told her not to say that in her testimony. Please. Yet now she has said it, Mr. Montcalm. How could you possibly see Mr. Edgeworth? Explain yourself.
Miss Hart?
What?
Could you see the defendant that night?
Of course! I said I could and I meant I could.
Then please testify to the circumstances of your sighting.
I did it. I finally found a home in Von Karma's carefully vague testimony.
You're right. It was a cold night, and the fog was thick as grits. So once I was finished setting up my camera, I got back in the car. Still, I brought my binoculars with me. When I heard that noise out on the lake, I looked with my binoculars. See? No problem.
You use binoculars? Very well. You may begin your cross-examination, Mr. Wright.
This one better be good.
So, how could you see Edgeworth?
Now, just hold your horses for a second. You hasty Yankee types and never find a gal where I'm from.
Defense attorneys have trouble with that as it is.
Nobody loves me.
Your camera?
Yeah, it's got an automatic.
The issue we are concerned with here is Ms. Hardmiss seeing Mr. Edgeworth. The camera has nothing to do with this at all.
Objection sustained.
Ah, he's not letting her answer any of my questions.
Binoculars? Yeah, binoculars. Yesterday you mentioned that you were out looking for shooting stars, correct? Well, yeah. Wouldn't you need a telescope, not binoculars, for that? Oh! I've got doubts about your camera, too. Was that really to take pictures of meteor showers?
The camera is irrelevant to this case.
You can't say that for certain.
Mr. Wright, is the camera really relevant to this case? If you believe it is, you may continue with this line of questioning.
But know this, if you find nothing with this, there will be consequences.
Well, Mr. Wright?
Maybe it's time I do a little cheeky save scum. Okay, a little intimidated here.
Do you wish to press further about the camera?
Hell yes, I do. This is make it or break it time.
The camera is of utmost importance, Your Honor. It is perhaps the key to this entire case. Therefore, I will continue my line of questioning. Point!
Wow, maybe I went a little overboard there.
Very well. Ms. Hart, you will testify to the court about the camera.
Yeah, I hear ya. Camera is set up to take pictures of meteor shower.
Ms. Hart, what made you choose that lake to photograph meteors? You know the fog gets thick on that lake. It's not very suited to stargazing.
Yeah, well, you see, I guess I wasn't thinking too straight. Ha!
Mr. Wright, I will not have you badgering my witness because of a challenged intellect.
Now, wait a minute.
Continue your testimony. You were saying how it was that you saw Edgeworth. No unnecessary comments, please.
When I heard that noise out on the lake, I looked with my binoculars.
If there was a heavy fog, how would binoculars change that at all?
What do you mean?
Even binoculars can't see through fog. But you say you clearly saw him?
I did, yeah.
Enough. There is no room for doubt in her testimony.
Court TVS broadcast of this trial was brought to you by Safe Spam.
Yay! Spam in the place where I live. She sounded pretty doubtful to me. But I have to find a clear contradiction first. I don't care how many Von Karmic objections I get. I'm going to find a hole in this testimony if it's the last thing I do.
You're right.
Alright, let's see. What have I got here that I can use against her? I think this is the time. Okay.
Your Honor, what do you think about the witness's statement?
I'm not sure I follow.
It clearly contradicts the, I thought...
You don't sound very convinced, Mr. Wright. Objection overruled.
Dang it. I don't think that won me any points with the judge.